we live in our country, India. Now, our country, India, provides us with so many different rights. We have the right to express our views. We have the right to live with dignity. We have the right to lead a happy and peaceful life. Now, all these are possible because our country gives us so many different rights. But with rights come duties too. So duties are inseparable from rights. Both are strictly complementary. So just like I have my rights, I also have my duties towards the nation. So the nation gives me my rights and I have to fulfill some duties towards the nation so that I deserve these rights. So you see, rights and duties both are complementary. And just like we enjoy certain rights from the country, we need to perform certain duties, which are called fundamental duties. So the Constitution has mentioned some fundamental duties which all citizens of this country are expected to perform. So what are fundamental duties? The fundamental duties are the morals and principles which tell us the way in which we should act to uphold the unity of our country. So what are fundamental duties? The fundamental duties are the morals and principles, right, which tell us the way in which we should act to uphold the unity of our country. So only when we perform all these duties, we deserve all the rights we get. And one of the very important fundamental duties is to respect the Constitution, the national flag, and the national anthem. Now, the Constitution, the national flag, and the national anthem are the symbols of our country. Well, we live in a democratic country, and the life which we have because of this Constitution, this country. So it's very important that we respect it, because in many countries they don't have as much freedom as we have. So this freedom which we get because of our Constitution and our country. So we should respect the symbols of our country, that is the Constitution, the national flag, and the national anthem. So as you know, whenever you hear the national anthem, you always stand upright to respect the national anthem. Similarly, when the national flag is hoisted, you stand upright and salute it, because the national flag is the symbol of our nation and we should respect it. Similarly, we should respect the Constitution of India, because the Constitution gives us all the rights and the freedom which we have. So we should always respect the symbols of our country, our state, that is India. Also, it is our duty to promote harmony and the spirit of common brotherhood amongst all the people of India. So you see, we all citizens of India together make up this country, isn't it? Now, everybody is free to follow their own beliefs. So all of us are together like a family in this country. So we may have different beliefs or we may follow different religions, but we are all Indians, and it is our responsibility to promote harmony and spirit of common brotherhood in our country, so that our country is united and we are all living like a family. So you see, this is also a very important fundamental duty of all citizens of India. Now, you must have noticed, whenever you go to some monument, that is historical monument, you must have seen such images, that is people have written names or scribbled something else on the historical monuments. Sometimes people knowingly or unknowingly damage these monuments. Now, that is not to be done. It is completely wrong, because it is our duty to value and preserve the rich heritage of our entire culture. And these monuments actually represent the rich heritage of our entire culture, and it is our responsibility to protect and preserve it. So what should we do? We should not perform these activities, because by performing these activities, we are damaging our rich heritage, and that is very disrespectful. Our country has given us so many rights, and it is our duty to value and preserve the rich heritage of our entire culture and our country. So, to value and preserve the rich heritage of our entire culture, this is a fundamental right or a fundamental duty. What do you think? Well, it is a fundamental duty. So, it is our duty to value and preserve the rich heritage of our entire culture. Now, another important fundamental duty of ours is to protect and improve the natural environment, including forests, lakes, rivers, and wildlife, and to have compassion for living creatures. So you see, all these wildlife and our environment itself, it's very important for our survival, and these are part of our country. So it is our responsibility to preserve and protect them. So illegal hunting of wild animals as well as cutting off trees in the forest is illegal, and it is our duty to preserve and protect them, because only if the environment is protected, we all can have proper lives. Without environment, we cannot exist. So protection and preservation of the environment is our foremost duty. So it is our duty to protect and improve the natural environment of our country. Now, another important fundamental duty is to safeguard public property and to avoid violence. So what exactly do you see here? Well, people are actually damaging public property, which is for the good of all, and it is definitely a wrong practice. It is our fundamental duty to safeguard public property and to avoid violence. So it's very important that we do not carry out such activities. We should always protect public property of our country. So you see, these were some of the important fundamental duties which we have as citizens of this country. So we should always respect the symbols of our country. We should live in harmony and peace. We should preserve our heritage. We should protect our environment and wildlife. And it is our duty to safeguard public property, because public property is available for all of us, and all the citizens of India share them. So all these things are our responsibility, and only when we perform these duties, we deserve to have the rights which Constitution of India has given us. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can also register for free at deltastep.com to get all learning resources as per ICSE, CBSE, IB, Cambridge, or any other curriculum. Over 5,000 amazing lectures across maths, science, English, and social science. Our unique interactive video technology keeps you engaged, and our iDictionary feature allows you to quickly revise any concept. Master each topic at your own pace with our adaptive practice technology and 1 million plus questions. Get instant answers and detailed solutions. Be exam ready by taking unlimited mock tests. performance analysis along with actionable feedback, personal tutors to resolve your slightest of doubts. That's not all. You also get amazing prizes like PlayStations, iPads, watches, and many more, along with certificates through our Earn As You Learn program. So at DeltaStep.com, learning is not just fun and easy, it's rewarding too. So register for free now.